It's Ellen Holstein, Community Program Manager from Pierce Cedar Creek Institute. Today I have a fun activity with tracks and scat and learning about animals. So tracks are basically the footprints of animals, and you see them all over in nature. A lot of times you can see them at this time of year in mud and in sand. Whereas scat is basically another word for animal poop. Who doesn't like to learn about poop? But poop has lots of different names. You could call it waste, you could call it frass, for example, for insects. You could call it castings for earthworms. You can call it pies, for example, cow pies. And it can come in many different shapes. It can be tubular, so kind of like a sausage. It could also be more pellet-like. It could also just look like a big old splat. What you think of mostly for birds, that white splat that you sometimes see on the sidewalk. So in today's activity, we have different matchup cards that you're going to be cutting out and you're going to be trying to match up. So included in this video, you're going to get some handouts, and the handouts are going to look a little bit like this. So on one side is going to be the scat, so remember that animal poop, and on the other side you're going to have different animals. So you're going to cut up all of these, and then you're going to try to match the different scat to the different animal. When you're doing this, try to look at the scat. See if you can find different bits of, for example, in this one you can see some fur and maybe some bones. Or this one you see different colors in it, like white versus this one's a little bit more gray. When you're looking at it, also look at the size of it. Maybe that can tell you which animal it comes from. So do your best and try to match it up. I also have included the key to let you know if you did it right or not. And once you have done that, you can also use the food cards. So once you've actually matched them up, then try to match up the food cards to the scat. The food cards basically give you an idea of what different animals eat. So for example, birds, or grass, or let's see what else I have here, small animals. So try to match up a food to the frass or the scat. Also, you might notice on the food cards there's words such as carnivore or herbivore. So if you remember these terms, carnivore is an animal that mainly eats meat, whereas herbivore is an animal that mainly eats plants. See if you can also match those things up with the particular animals and scat. So that's our scat activity. For our animal tracking activity, we also have cards that have footprints or tracks on them and different animal pictures. Again, see if you can match up the animal with the footprint. Now, when you're looking at the footprints, you want to observe different things. It does tell you different sizes on them, so that's one thing. You might also notice there are different numbers of toes, or you may see claw marks on them. So when you're looking at them, try to think of what animals might have that many toes or might have those types of claws. Try to see if you can match them up. Again, there is a key in the handouts here. If you do not have a printer to be able to print out all these materials, I have included websites that you can actually go online and actually do a matchup type of game online. There's a couple of websites, one for scat and one for animal tracks. So I hope you guys enjoy this activity, learn a lot about animal tracks and animal scat, and I'll see you next time for our next activity. Bye, guys!